Thank you for tuning in to the Grand Solar Minimum channel. This video is a part of our learning series. Many people have been looking for a quick overview of exactly what a grand solar minimum is. Some are here today just curious of the different views of climate change. So let's dive in. As a primer to this video, I recommend my breakdown on the differences between a solar cycle, a grand cycle, and a super grand solar cycle. For hundreds of millions of years, changes in solar activity have been associated with changes from warming to cooling and back again. The long run to the recent peak in activity was the strongest in thousands of years. Despite this, temperatures were not as warm for as long as set during the medieval warm period. The deep dive into the cooler climate in the early 1300s was drastic, causing widespread crop failures and famine in northern Europe and England. The die-off from 1315 to 1320 is estimated at some 10% of the population. Deaths of cattle, sheep, and horses were severe as well, all due to the turn to cold and unusually wet weather. A new change to what some are calling the modern minimum or eddy minimum is significant. NASA has confirmed solar cycle 25, the next solar cycle is expected to be significantly weaker than that of the current cycle. NOAA has also released predictions that the next solar cycle will be the lowest we have seen in 200 years. This is also supported in Valentina Zarkova's latest research, which predicts the next modern grand minimum of solar activity between 2020 and 2055. Her paper also shows how the warming trends over time are a part of a natural cycle. 200 years ago, we were in what we call a grand solar minimum, the Dalton minimum, an extended lull of solar activity. This chart is an easy visual to see how our solar cycles rise and fall. Right now, we are forecasted for a very steep decline. Like the Maunder minimum and the Spohr minimum, the Dalton minimum coincided with a period of lower than average global temperatures. The year without a summer occurred during the Dalton minimum in 1816. The prime reason for that year's cool temperatures was the highly explosive 1815 eruption of Mount Tambora in Indonesia. This was one of the two largest eruptions in the past 2,000 years. The cause of lower than average temperatures and their probable relation to low sunspot count are not well understood. The most likely cause I have found is from papers that link low solar activity and cosmic rays to volcanic activity. Cosmic rays are currently on the rise. With the modern grand minimum, as history has shown with prior grand minima, we will have these Earth changes. With this change comes a threat to our food supply, something many of us have had a glimpse of this year. Last year's crop was not too bad, and yet we are seeing shortages this year. It is very concerning to see the struggles our farms are going through. We have had farms not getting anything into the ground or being flooded out and having to replant to just getting a late start due to poor soil conditions. The numbers are looking bleak for this year's crop, and we are facing a predicted early frost by many professional forecasters. We can no longer take for granted our food supply. We may have passed the breaking point, and only time will tell just how bad by this time next year. To be best prepared, learn to grow your own food and stock up what you can. It is very unfortunate that these natural cycles have been demonized to the masses as global warming, or now, as the temperatures have been cooling, the term climate change. Fingers are pointed at mankind because it is profitable. What a brilliant idea. Blaming mankind for CO2 so the powers that be can assign a tax and penalize its people. They have shown you starving polar bears. The ice caps are melting. Al Gore even promised your children would never see snow. They have twisted this natural cycle into your fault. It is fear for profit, and there is no science that proves CO2 is the main driver of our climate. In fact, most organizations such as NOAA and NASA define the sun as the primary driver of our climate. If this is true, and history has shown this to be true, why would we accept an international organization such as the IPCC, the International Panel on Climate Change, giving us reports that do not even have the contribution of a solar physicist? Think about that for a minute. We have a panel to direct people worldwide on the climate, yet the panel has zero solar physicists to contribute the very dire information about our sun. They tout they have climatologists. However, our climate is so much more complex than many simplify it to be. I'm sorry to offend anyone, but a climatologist is not 100% well-versed in all variables of our climate. What are some of the variables? Our sun, the solar forcing, our moon with lunar forcing, our magnetosphere, our ocean oscillations, the weather patterns. As I stated earlier, we have complexities like the increase of cosmic rays, which have been linked to earthquake and volcanic activity. There are changes that are happening in our atmosphere, the complexities of cloud nucleation, albedo effect, other space weather, and much more. The variables are complex and need researchers specially trained in each component to gain a full understanding. To this day, I have not found a group of researchers come together to truly assemble the big picture in a professional manner. There is simply no funding for it because the data points to a natural cycle, and that is not profitable. There's a lot of rhetoric, a lot of propaganda, and unfortunately, the mainstream profit machine is not out to protect the well-being of mankind. There's not a group of specialists or a panel that exists that is truly able to decipher what exactly our climate is doing. We must all zoom out and see there are many pieces to this puzzle. As a planet, we face many challenges. Just look at the extreme weather, floods, drought, food shortages. All these will intensify as this cycle progresses. We are threatened by power grid failures from geomagnetic storms, asteroids, political uprising in some countries, the vulnerable state of the monetary systems. These things may happen, they may not happen. The important message I want you to take from this is be prepared. Do not rely on anyone but yourself to get you prepared. This is something you cannot put off. The best practice is to be prepared. We at GSM hope for the best, but prepare for the worst. Have a plan, that is all you can do. I encourage you to research this topic further and research it from all sides. No one truly knows what the future holds. We must learn from our history and take steps to adapt to these natural cycles. You cannot stop climate change. The only thing you can do is adapt. Have you learned from history? How well prepared will you be? I will be covering many of the climate variables and history in separate videos as a part of this learning series. Thank you for tuning in to the Grand Solar Minimum channel. Please like and share.